So in previous videos of mine, I've talked a lot about money-making methods, but I haven't really focused much on CEXP. So I figured in today's video, I'm gonna try to make the most efficient CEXP grinder on the server. Now, like all my other video ideas, this once again will take a fair amount of money to set up, but to be honest, this one's probably worth it. Now currently as it is, I have 20,000 CEXP, and throughout the season, I've probably gained upwards of like 100,000. But you know, the one issue with that is, I've only gained 4,100 of it from farming mobs. The rest of it, I've gotten from mining. Now, I know mining is a good way to make money, but it's not even close to the most efficient when it comes to getting CEXP, so we need to get some spawners. Now, of course, big shout out to the people who actually made up this method. In no ways am I claiming this is my own method. Also, I'll link the channel who first uploaded this strategy to YouTube. You can go check out his video. It'll be linked in the description. Of course, with that said, please subscribe if you're not, and let's get started. Now, from selling some kits, I've actually got 3.4 million, and hopefully that'll be enough for the spawners we want to buy. Now, to do this, we're probably going to need like a stack or two of zombie spawners. And currently right now, I've only got 22 tier 1s and a single tier 3. So I think if I can get a stack of tier 4 zombie spawners, I think that would be the best. Now I know this may sound like a dumb question, but I figured I'd ask. I just wanted to make sure. So currently I've got 23, so if I do 64 minus 23, I need 41 more zombie spawners. Now before I go asking chat to sell zombie spawners, I want to check, see how much they're going for. Now we got one for 200k, and oh, but that's 10 million for 56. That's definitely not worth. Now, it'll probably cost us quite a lot to get all of these to tier 4. So what I'm gonna do, I wanna try upgrading a single one all the way up to tier 4 and see how much that costs. And oh, wow, okay. Just for one to go to tier 2, it's gonna cost us 640k, wow. I'm gonna be honest, that may not be worth it. All right, let's see if anyone's selling them in chat. Yo, big shout out to Relief. He just gave me 5 free zombie spawners. This guy actually does have a YouTube channel. You guys should totally check it out. He makes some really good videos. Anyways though, thank you, thank you. All right, so let's see. We were told we get like, yeah, 45 zombie spawners for a YouTube kit and an Aether kit. I think that's a pretty fair deal. Now we've got just over a stack of zombie spawners. So thank you, King Jellybeans. And well, now I think it's time we start making some profit. Also, already at our base, we have 17 of these placed, so hopefully with all of these, we should be able to make a fair amount of zombies from this. Anyways, let's place all these zombie spawners, and hopefully we should be able to just stack all these up, and we'll be good. And there we go, we've got a total of like 8 unique spawners here, most of them have stacks of 10. And now, let's see how many zombies we get from this. And oh wow, we're like really gaining them up quick. Anyways, let's grab out this Hecate sword. From what I was told, this is like the best for grinding. I believe with this, I can one-hit the zombies. Also, Zeon is gonna show me like some strategy where like I have to hit the zombie, and then he's gonna go kill them, and I'm gonna get like the loot or something. I'm holding right now an Artemis sword with looting 4. And oh, my entire inventory is full. Oh, this is crazy. So there's a couple of different strategies that you can use to kill the zombies. Right now, I'm actually using one that requires 2 different people, and that allows you to get the most amount of money and the most amount of CEXP. Basically, as he kills the zombies, I'm holding the sword and I'm getting the drops from it. It's really hard to explain, I'm gonna be honest, but it's like super OP. I'll show other ways that don't involve 2 people, but this is a really good one. And as soon as your inventory fills up, you just sell inventory and you just keep making more money. Also, when I go to CE shop now, I was at 20,000. I'm already at 21,000. Now I'm gonna use this strategy just for a little bit here and see how much we make. And I'm already up another like 400 from that. Wow, this is so quick. Oh, I'm making so much. My inventory is just filling right up. This is so crazy. I'm like literally running out of space. I gotta like put away my extra set and stuff. Anyway, so there's a lot of different swords that you can use for this. Depending on whether you want like CEXP from the zombies or if you want money. YouTube sword is good. Easter sword is good. Hecate right here is good. Pretty much you're just looking for looting or smite. Smite will give you more CEXP because that allows you to one hit them. But if you have looting, that'll give you a lot more money. So pretty much it's just up to you. This method that I was just showing you with 2 people allows you to get the most of both. But keep in mind, you need a second person to do it. Watch how quickly he kills them, and watch my inventory just fill up with rotten flesh. Like, I'm not even speeding this up or anything. Just look at how quickly I get rotten flesh from this. There we go. That was like 180 of them, and I got like that many stacks of rotten flesh. And when I sell that, there we go, that's 69,000 coins in less than a minute. And I'm already up at 22,000 CEXP. Anyway, so that's how you do it with 2 people, but now I'm gonna show you the best methods if it's just if you're just by yourself. So I know I could use my Easter sword, but the issue with this is it doesn't one hit them. As you see, I hit it once and I have to hit them twice just to kill them. So the Easter sword is kind of off the table for now. Now currently I don't have any YouTube swords, but I know that one's a really good one for grinding. Keep in mind though, if you are using a YouTube sword, you are gonna need strength potions so that you can one hit the zombies. But if you're using a Hecate sword or something else with Smite 5, because Smite deals more damage to zombies, I can literally one hit the zombies as I hit them. Now it helps to just tap the zombies with your fist once. Sometimes that'll allow the zombie drops to go straight in your inventory. Something might be a little glitched right now, but there we go. Now they're going straight into my inventory. But when I go to CE shop right now, I've got 23,461. Keep that number in mind because I'm going to grind. I'm gonna kill all 90 of these zombies and see where we're at now. Okay, there we go. From just like 60 zombies, I got over 200 CE XP. So now I'm all the way up at 23,000. So if you're looking for a good sword, Hecate is pretty good. It's relatively cheap compared to the YouTube sword, but if you're looking to make more money, you do want to take the investment and try to find a YouTuber who's going to sell a YouTube kit. That's pretty much me like every day. Generally though, I'll sell them for like 2 to 3 million coins on Auction House, so don't go messaging me for a YouTube kit because generally I'll just put them on AH and they'll sell pretty quick. Anyways though, I'm just gonna be using this Hecate sword. I should probably put this Easter G sword away, but I'm just gonna keep it on me. I can't really be bothered. Anyways, there we go. Yeah, as I hit it once. That means all the drops are immediately going straight into my inventory here. I don't have to worry about them like despawning on the ground or anything. And there we go. I cannot kill them fast enough as they just keep spawning in. Every time it gets to like 100, more will spawn in. This right here is peak efficiency. And the nicest part is lag doesn't really affect this. Anyways, I'm gonna speed some things up and I'm gonna go all the way up from me being at 24,000 CE XP all the way up to 50,000. Cause you know, I need some CE bucks for my G set. Anyways, of course, this will take quite some time, so I'm probably not gonna include too much into this, but let's get started. Dumb. Another guy tried to TP trap me. I wanted to see the base that they said he blew up, and I got TP trapped, but now you're probably dead here. I'm in a G set. I don't think there's much you can do. Come on. My armor's still chilling. I have no pots left either, though. Why do I accept TPAs? I'm so dumb. Oh, you're so dumb. Well, I guess never trust this guy again. Alright, so I'm just under 1,000 CE XP away from 50k, so I'm just gonna start grinding this up here. I will start explaining a couple of the issues that we've had so far. I started to notice that actually whenever items clear lag, these zombies will as well. I don't know if this is a new thing or not, but yeah, it's, yeah, right there. I just lost like a stack of like 100 of them, which is a little bit of an issue, but with the amount of zombie spawners I have, it doesn't really matter too much, and I'm so far just in this little bit of time, I've gained over like 300 now. Yeah, it's kind of annoying though when they despawn. Also, sometimes they'll do like this and they'll spawn in the wall, and then like sometimes you're not able to get the drops from them or the CEXP. Yeah, like this. They're just dying in the hole. And okay. Then you have to do stuff like this, and it's just a little weird. I hate when this happens. Also, the nice part is I'm gaining mob coins and money from the rotten flesh I'm selling. So on top of this, after I have 50,000 CE XP, I should have a lot of mob coins. I can maybe buy like some sea eggs or forge dust or something. I don't know. We'll see. Anyways, we are just coming up on 50,000. We are so incredibly close. I don't know how much these give. Let me try just killing one. I want to be at exactly 50,000 though. Oh, I may not be able to get it exactly. Oh, it's because of that CE perk or whatever. I'm gonna be like so close, but oh no. I'm one away, but there's no way I can get a single one. Oh well. Let's just do that. There we go, 50,001. It's not perfect, but it's the best I could do. Anyways, I think it's about time we go to CE shop, and I think we might have to start opening some now. All right, so if I do commons, I can open up 41 of them, but if I do epics, I can only open up 13. So I think I'm gonna do all common. Let's go back to my main base here, and let's go CE shop, and let's open up a whole bunch of commons. I'll have to like stop midway through, but rip. All this time and effort all just going down the drain here, just opening up a whole bunch of commons. Oh, this is kind of painful, not gonna lie. Let's see what we got so far. All right, we got Golden Touch, that's good. Berserker, no, not really. I mean, it's okay, I guess. Diamond Touch, that's another good pickaxe one. Iron, okay, wow, we're getting some really good pickaxe ones. All right, we got another sword one. Another good sword one. Ooh, shield. That's good. Bloom. Okay, these are like armor ones. Okay, that's pickaxe. And we got black dust and black magic. I'm looking for like armor CEs mostly. I need like steel bones and stuff. I guess let's keep opening up a whole bunch of these. And we're just under halfway done. So I really hope I'm getting like steel bones. That's everything. I can't open up another. I guess let's see what else we got here. We got a lightning, two unstable, digger, lifesteal, iron army, core, haze, icebound, three more iron touch. Wow. Cursed. That's a good armor CE. Immunity. That's good. Diamond touch. Okay. Full moon. More. Oh, I have so many black magics. Vampire. Yes, we got steel bones. Let's go. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what we got from like an hour and a half of mining. It's not good, not bad, I guess.